Prop 8.
Yep.
The equality measure around marriage. Mm-hmm.
The idea that we have people who do not have rights equal to others is ridiculous.
That election for Attorney General fell on a couple issues in particular, but one is that my opponent said he would defend Prop 8, which would have banned same-sex marriage, and I said I would not defend it.
Frankly, Rachel, as the daughter of parents who were active in the civil rights movement, I refuse to stand in the doorway of the wedding chapel blocking same-sex couples' ability to marry.
I fought to defend people's right to marry the person they love. And then the word came back that we had won the case. And I got a call, the plaintiffs have asked that you would be the person to perform their marriage. And I was like, are you kidding me? Of course. And so we walked into City Hall, and while we were there, the other plaintiffs, a couple who were in Los Angeles, were trying to get married there, and the clerk wouldn't do it.
We cannot do anything until we hear from the state.
Somebody told me what's going on, and they passed me the phone.
Excuse me, I've got the Attorney General on the phone right here.
You must start the marriages immediately.
All right, I will take that as our notice.
That's wonderful, thank you. Have a good day and enjoy it. It's gonna be fun.
I'm looking forward to it. Okay.
By virtue of the power and authority vested in me by the state of California, I now declare you spouses for life.
That was a moment in the history of the ongoing fight for the civil rights of people. There are some things for which we should have no patience, because justice delayed is justice denied. When we are talking about the fight for civil rights and for equality and equal justice under law, we should not have so much patience that we deny people justice.